Hi, I'm Paul from the Tech Geeks. In this short video, a bit of rough and ready, I'm just going to hopefully answer a few questions that we've been asked about the Cloud Gateway Max, the UCG Max. Plenty of conversations about speed and can it actually perform. And so I thought we've had this on the testbed. I was recording a bigger long video yesterday that shows some of this, but I thought maybe I would just record just a small segment just to show you what we've done and what we've seen that maybe will give you an idea of what we think this can actually achieve. So remember, this unit has all of the ports, all five of them are 2.5 gigabit a second. So let me just talk to you about our environment here. The WAN of this UCG Max is connected to the 10 gig SFP port on our USW-Pro-Max-16. That has got an SFP port connector in it, SFP plus, down to an RJ45, so it's the RJMG, RJ45MG Ubiquiti device add-in transceiver there. And that drops the speed down to then 2.5 gig a second. So you can see here that we're running the WAN interface as it's full. This is an out-of-the-box setup. So it's just come out of factory defaults. I've added a camera because I was recording some other videos there. We've then got a 10 gig internet or a 10 gig connection with inside our office where we've got our iPerf server, and we've got a 1 gig internet connection. So let me just show you so you can see some of those bits. So out of the box, let's just run. This is using the speed test app. It's always better to use the app more than the one built into the web browser. So you can see here that we're pretty close to our full internet connection speed because, again, with overheads and we're testing going out to the internet, I'm not probably going to see an actual 1 gig a second. And I'm not so worried about upload and download differences. I know that there's about a gig available to me. So we'll just let that finish. And out the box, let me show you where this is at. So just so that you assure that I've got this set up as I need to, I can go to security here and we can see that intrusion prevention here is currently off. We don't have anything sitting in our firewall tables here. And so that is all as it should be. So let's just come back to here again. So let's go to our iPerf test and let's run that. So I'm doing this on DHCP. Let's be really clear about this. So I know that there are issues where authentication is used. I can't test that because my internet service provider doesn't require me to pass a username and password. So if you just generally only need to pick up an IP address on the WAN using DHCP, so you're not using IPOE, I think it is, or IPPPOE, or you're not using PPPOE, both of those need authentication, a username and password, and essentially it create a tunnel. I'm aware that there are issues that you're probably only going to get less than a gig a second if you're doing that. This is on a true just picking up an IP address from my upstream providers. So you can see out of the box, this immediately makes me go, this is rubbish. Because you can see only 750 megasecond. So let's say that's maybe 800, 900 megasecond with the overheads. So right out of the box, that makes me think this unit cannot achieve the 2.5 gigabits a second of throughput it's meant to. Well, that's fine, but I don't believe that's totally truthful. And let me show you why. So out of the box, we've got to remember that all of these switching speeds are very interesting in what we expect them to do as an auto negotiation. So if we were actually to go to the port manager here and have a look, I can actually see the port that this computer, this that we're actually logged into and doing this test on, this is actually only connected at a gig a second, even though I've got this plugged into a 2.5 gigabit a second port on my Pro Max. So this gives me an idea that actually this port is struggling to work out how to also negotiate. So what I'm actually going to go and do is I'm actually going to move this manually to a different port speed. All right, and see, so this is the first thing that we've noticed. So you're going to come into manual, and if you, obviously you can only do this if you're connecting this on the LAN side to a 2.5 gigabit a second device, a switch or something like that. Also, remember, you might have to do this on your WAN as well, depending on how that's set up. So I've just now set that to 2.5, and I'm looking for that to go blue. All right, that's my key. So let's check to see that we've still got a ping and we've not lost it. Let's let it renegotiate, hopefully for a moment. In a minute, it will be able to reconnect and we'll have some access back out to the internet. There we go. So that port speed has renegotiated. So let's just, oh, I can bring that back on a slightly bigger mic. The computer we were using there has dropped away. So let's just do this. So let's just refresh this page here. All right, so we should see now two ports running at 2.5 gigs. So let's just do our speed test. Remember, this shouldn't actually change because of the simple fact that I've only got a 1 gig internet connection. And there you go, we're still sitting at that 800-900 megasecond. As soon as we clock over that high 800s to early 900s, that's really a gig with the overheads. So let's just let that finish running. And then we're going to go back to our iPerf test. All right, and we're going to see what performance we can actually get out of the unit at that point. So let's come back to our iPerf. Remember before, only 758 megasecond. So hitting iPerf here, let's see what we can run. Look, 1.5, 1.7, 1.7, 1.6, 1.8, 1.7, 1.6, 1.6. So we have got almost twice the speed we were getting before, where we were getting 700 or 800 megasecond. We are now getting 1.6 to between 1.6 and 1.8 gigabits a second. You say, well, that's great. Okay, but that's no intrusion prevention or anything else running. So that's fine. But at least we've done the first step. Remembering, I'm only doing this with DHCP. I'm not doing this with PPPoE or IPoE, whichever it is, IPPoE. All right. And at the moment, IPS is not turned on. But my first change here is that I actually am testing this with a device on the LAN that truly is connected at 2.5 gigabits a second by setting that port. Remember, we had to set that port manually, that WAN port, manually down here on an override to get the speed that we needed to do. So now let's head into security for this. All right, so let's go to security here. We'll go to intrusion prevention. We won't go to auto. We'll go straight to advanced. We're going to hit it up onto high, and we're just going to let it save those changes. So filtering mode is on as notify, high sensitivity. All of the other options are on. So we're just going to give that a moment to get that happening. We've got no problems there with our ping. So let's again run our speed test. All right, so 1.4, 1.3, 1.7, 1.7, 1.5. Now, over the last 25, 27 years, I've done a lot with firewalls. And so when it comes to talking about the stats and things that we see on this, it's very easy to comment about how this is going to look and whatever goes with it. We are going to see a fluctuation on speed because as we look for threats, we can identify that something isn't a threat and then let that traffic stream through. So we are going to get a fluctuation. We're not going to be able to get necessarily a solid speed because we're going to be trying to interpret what's going on. So there you can see 1.2, 1.6, 1.4, 1.5. 1.5, 1.4. All right, so we sent 1.6 gig of data in a file in that short period of time. All right, and we've been able to get around about 1.4 gig a second. Remember, with IDS on, we were getting about 1.6, 1.7. So we're getting well over our 1 gig a second. I can tell you that many firewall vendors that charge 3, 4, 5, 6 times the price of the UCG Max still can't do that type of speed on this price point unit. So I think that's actually pretty good. There are a few other options that we've got, I think, from memory. We can do content filtering, I think, if we go to manual here and turn on that to be family friendly. As long as we've got those little bits in place and then we actually run that test again, we'll just give it a moment to run it again. There we go. So we can see there again that the test is pretty solid. Again, with that turned on, let's run it again. It's had a couple of minutes more. I just paused it for a moment. Again, we're seeing 1.2, 1.25, 1.5, 1.5. If you're hoping to every time do this, hit your speed test and get 2 gig a second, it's not going to do that. IPS will struggle to do that even on high priced devices. You are going to get a fluctuation, but this I'm looking for the maximum speed at any point in time it can do. And if that's 1.5, 1.6, that's a pretty good thing. Obviously, as we load this, we're going to see a drop in speed to a certain extent with more and more users on it because there's more stuff and to interpret. But as a general speed, hopefully you can see that. So maybe if I just go back just to conclude this video off and just show you it again, I'm just going to go back and turn the filtering to none. We're then just going to go to security and intrusion prevention and turn this to off. Actually, in fact, what we'll do is this. Let's leave this as on. Let's put this back on because some people ask about smart cues. So let's just do that. So let's put that as family as on. All right, let's go to remembering where it is in here. System, is it? I don't think it's here. Maybe it is. Let me just try and remember. Everybody screaming at me going, hey, I know where it is. I know where it is. And I've forgotten where it is. So let's just bear with me. Maybe that was on the internet connection. Where is smart cues in here? All right, let me just go and grab where that is. Oh, you can see where it is. I've just missed it. All right, so on our internet connection, all right, I'm just going to set this as turn smart cues on. You'll see in the bubble it says that this is not recommended for connections over 300 megasecond. On some of the previous models, I think when we tested on this, the UCG Ultra, that basically wouldn't run anything faster. Now, interestingly enough, you can't get a really big value in here. So it only allows you to get up to, you can't even change the megabytes there. So you can only run this at 1,000. So if you're running smart queues, you will be limited at a gig a second. All right, so hopefully the unit has got enough overheads to be able to allow smart queues to be enabled and do all the filtering and do everything else that's with it. So let's again just go back to our speed test. So we've still got IDS on, we've got smart queues turned on. All right, like I said to you, smart queues is not going to allow us to get any faster than a gig for the simple reason that that's the maximum that it's allowed to go up. But you can see that even with smart queues running, we are still getting that high 800s, which is an indication, or even we're getting some early 900s that you really are seeing a gig a second running on that. And we could just run over to our proper outside speed test, which won't be good while the other one's running. Here we go. Let's see what it can do. There we go. 700. And so that's not bad, again, testing out to the actual internet. So hopefully that's given you a few little things in there. If you are looking to do IDS and see your performance, you definitely can get over a gig. Hopefully you can see how I've done that. Remember, check your WAN and your LAN ports and make sure that they maybe have to be switched to manual duplexing or manual, and choose the right duplexing if that's something that hasn't set automatically on yours. Do remember, this is only relevant if you are just basically getting the IP address via DHCP. If you're getting it by PPPoE or IPPPoE, I can't test that because I don't have a provider that does it that way. But I do know that it will probably perform more like smart queues and probably only give you a gig a second because it's doing some level of tunneling in it. But hopefully that's been useful. Plenty more videos over on our YouTube channel, so subscribe and stay up to date.